energy. It's a big slice of the carbon cake. And what I think is really good about it is that here's one area where we actually have an influence as individuals. You and I, we can make a difference. We can decide whether or not we want to be part of the old polluting fossil fuel powered system, or whether we want to move over to something that doesn't pollute, something that gets cheaper and cheaper by the day. Each and every one of us has all the power it takes to switch over to a 100% green electricity provider. We can put solar on the roof. And as a matter of fact, that's what a lot of people are doing around the world. Here in Australia, more than 2 million households get their power straight from the roof and straight from the sun. And of course we do that because we save money that way. A solar system actually pays for itself over something like 5 years, and after that, the energy it produces is free. That's right. Free energy actually does exist. Where I come from, Denmark, we like to harness the wind. Already next year, this population of 5.5 million people, which is just about the same as here in Victoria, the Danes will be getting 70% of their electricity from renewable energy sources. To make that jump is an absolute no-brainer. But we need to get smarter about how we use the energy. Because when all of us begin to switch over to renewables in big numbers, and when we begin to really rely on what we produce at home on our own roofs, we'll have to get smarter and use less energy. About half of what we're using today. That's doable. But it will require that we find out how to do it. Maybe even some investments. New machines, new fridges, new stoves, and so on. We have to get used to using less energy. Our houses also need better insulation. So when we talk about energy, we certainly also talk about renovating and retrofitting your home, modernizing it, making it fit for a low carbon lifestyle.
There's such a huge impact in, you know, the energy that goes into the production of housing and the use of houses, actually. And that, you know, up to 33% of the actual Earth's resources are being utilised to build and use sort of buildings, you know. So it is a huge contributor to the impacts that are happening on our climate here, you know. So, and that's our responsibility, you know. It's not the government's responsibility. These are our houses. This is our sort of lifestyle. It's what we've developed. We've got a responsibility, I think, to really actually take this on and try and reduce that impact, you know. And we can do that really easily by designing much cleverer buildings, you know, buildings that are responsive to our climate, you know, and allow people to actually sort of interact with them and not have to think a lot, I suppose, about being really sustainable, you know, because the hardest thing that we have to implement is trying to change people's behaviour, you know. It's really, really difficult. So if we can design buildings that are a little bit intuitive and actually respond to the climate without people having to sort of think about it, you know, then it's going to be a lot easier for that sort of, I think, to happen over time.
The house we bought in 2015 is 100 years old. And I tell you, when it's cold outside, it's just as cold inside. And the same, when there's a heat wave outdoor, we certainly feel that indoor. I invited some of my friends over to give me some advice on what they thought I should do and where we should start. And every one of them said, don't think you can do it all at once. Start with just one thing. And then maybe some months later, fix another one. So that's how I've been going about it over the years, one step at a time. I started with the insulation on the roof and under the floor. Then we replaced one window, then another. And then one day when we got a new neighbor, a Danish carpenter who just moved in next door, studying at the university here in Geelong, Kenneth, he had a look at our shed at the back and the garage, and he said, why don't we make it into like a tiny house, a sustainable, usable, climate-safe, multifunction room where the temperature always stays the same, no matter what the weather is like outside.
We build houses to last 100 years, at least.
We all have an energy journey ahead of us. Each one will be different. How much or how little you want to do the practical work yourself, that's actually not the issue. There is no excuse not to get started on this part of the transition. I've made that promise to myself, that commitment, that declaration that I want to go zero carbon within the next 5-6 years. By 2025, all electric, zero carbon and zero pollution into the atmosphere. It'll be cheaper, it'll be healthier, it'll be better, more comfortable and super satisfying. And I'm inviting you and my neighbors and everyone I know and everyone I meet to join me on this journey to put the carbon and the pollution behind us.